गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कंपाउंड्स एंड मिक्सचर्स. स्टूडेंट्स, अर्लियर टू दिस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट मिक्सचर्स, दैट इज वाटर मिक्सचर्स, एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड अबाउट कंपाउंड्स. नाउ वी विल डिफरेंशिएट बोथ ऑफ देम. सो लेट अस बिगिन. स्टूडेंट्स, टॉकिंग अबाउट कंपाउंड्स and mixtures, let us see the very first difference. So as always said, the very first difference will be their definition. So talking about compounds are the substances that are made up of atoms of two or more element combined together in a fixed proportion. Okay, but students, talking about mixture, they are made up of two or more pure substances that are mixed in any proportion. That is, their proportion is not fixed, but here in case of compound, proportion is fixed. Now students, let's talk about the second difference. So compounds have definite formula, as you can see, like carbon dioxide, like water, but mixture do not have any definite formula. Mixture do not have any different formula. Now students, talking about third difference. So compounds are always homogeneous, okay, but talking about mixtures, they may be homogeneous, they may be heterogeneous. Now students, talking about compounds. So compounds cannot be separated into their constituent by simple method. Okay, that is, we cannot separate the constituent of a compound by simple methods. Likewise, if we want to separate carbon dioxide through filtration or component of water through filtration, we cannot separate them. We will again get water, water and water only. Okay, but talking about mixture, so mixture can be separated into their constituent by simple method. That is, suppose we are taking a salt solution or we are taking a sand solution. Suppose we are taking sand solution, so it is a mixture of sand and water. We can filter it, we can get the sand particles aside, that is separated from the water. This is what the fourth difference. Now talking about the fifth one. So properties of compound are totally different from those of their constituent. We have discussed earlier also, suppose we are considering a compound, that is NaCl. So if we are talking separately about sodium, then sodium is a very reactive element. It can react even with water also. But talking about overall compound, that is sodium chloride, it is neutral. Okay, now students, mixtures shows properties of their constituent. I have earlier also told you, suppose we are taking a salty solution, that is we are adding a salt in a water. Suppose there is a container, here is water and we are adding salt to it. Okay, so whatever portion of this solution we will taste, it will be salty. So it means that mixture shows properties of their constituent. Now the sixth difference, that is compounds have fixed melting and boiling point. So students, any compound, whatsoever compound you will consider, they have a fixed melting and boiling point. But talking about mixtures, they do not have fixed melting or boiling points. Okay, now at last we will see examples for both. So for compounds, it may be CO2, that is carbon dioxide, it may be H2O, that is water, it may be NH3, that is ammonia, it may be CH4, that is methane, it may be H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid. There are many more. Talking about example of mixtures, it may be salt in water, that is salty solution, it may be sugar in water, that is sugary solution, it may be tea, which is a solution, or it is basically a mixture of you can see the tea leaves, water and many more, whatever the substances you are adding to it. And talking about milk, okay, as you all know that milk is a milk is having compositions of water, fat, milk protein, lactic acid, etc. So this is all about today's lecture. Thank you, class.